Good morning, everyone. It's Friday. We celebrate the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary. So let us begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
You know, it seems like we just can't say enough about Mary and all the things she did on her journey through life. At a very young age, she gives birth to Jesus, and all kinds of things kind of go wrong, and yet she somehow kept her focus. And I'm sure we've met people that the same way. Nothing seems to go right in life, and yet they're peaceful, they're happy. So they must have some of what Mary had, at least to some degree. So as you begin, let's think about ourselves. And when things go wrong, do we give up, do we get angry, or do we turn to God? For the times we fail to trust in God, we ask God's forgiveness. And so we pray, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Impart to us, O Lord, the gifts of heavenly grace, that the feast and the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin may bring ever deeper peace to those for whom the birth of her Son was the dawning of salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. The Lord says, "You Bethlehem, Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient times. Therefore the Lord will give them up until the time when she who is to give birth has born, and the rest of his brethren shall return to the children of Israel. He shall stand firm and shepherd his flock by the strength of the Lord, in the majestic name of the Lord his God. And they shall remain, for now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth. He shall be peace, the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. With delight I rejoice in the Lord.
With delight I rejoice in the Lord.
Though I trusted in your mercy, let my heart rejoice in your salvation. With delight I rejoice in the Lord. Let me sing of the Lord. He has been good to me.
With delight I rejoice in the Lord.
Friends, may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us be attentive to this reading of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son. You are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sin." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Got to thinking the other night about a lot of things, one of which was back in the seminary days that Father O'Neill took us, and what we were supposed to do. We got some foodstuffs. He paid for it. We got some bread and some, I call them cold cuts and stuff like that. And what we did, he brought them to the seminary. We made sandwiches for these people that lived in a very poor section of town. And this was during Lent we did it. And so we made the sandwiches, and we went down in various vehicles to go to this place where they were gathered, kind of like a center place. And as we were carrying in the sandwiches, one guy said to Father O'Neill, he said, "What do you want us to do? We'll serve them, but what else do you want us to do?" He said, "Sit down with them and eat." He said, "But it's Lent, and I fasted on meat. He said, "I don't care what you fasted on." He said, "You sit down with them and eat." He said, "But why, Father? We made them for them." He said, "Because if you don't sit down with them and eat, all you're going to do is remind them of their poverty." And it got me to thinking back in 2011 when we had the flood, and how the marvelous people here fed people for over a month. And watching them in action, they understood what Father O'Neill understood. They just sit down with them and eat, and they talk. And so they became one. And isn't that really what Christ called us to do? To be one. When we come to church, we're one. We are all children of God. We're reminded of that. Here is where it gets reminded over and over and over again. We all need to be reminded. So I'd ask you, you know, sometimes we have the best of intentions, but sometimes, like, we go about it the wrong way. But sometimes someone will lead us in reminding us of what Christ did. God bless. Do we truly follow the example of the blessed Mother who trusted that your words to her would be fulfilled? We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as we heard in the gospel today, we may never lose sight that God is with us. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those preparing to leave this life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For children, both those born and those waiting to be born, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we eat this bread to give you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we eat this wine to give you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Friends, let us pray that our gifts will be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of God's holy church.
As we celebrate with joy the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we bring our offerings, O Lord, and we humbly pray to be given the strength by the humanity of your Son, who from her was pleased to take flesh, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, it is truly right and just that we gather together to give you our thanks and our love. But for the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light. And so we truly join our loved ones in heaven as we pray this hymn of unending praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread
and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop. Remember Angelo Alfano and John Gillis, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. For all those who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that, together with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. May we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
We pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait with joyful hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
Offer to one another a sign of God's love. Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
O Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. As we celebrate the gift of the Blessed Virgin Mary, may we continue to trust in you as she did on her journey back home to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God's blessing continue to guide us in all that we do, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go now in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good weekend, everyone.